but for future generations. That stimulus works out to about $9,900, just over that, per person. Raise your hand if you've been helped by the stimulus. No, we haven't had help from the stimulus. Now, that's not a partisan statement, it's just a fact. It's an economic fact, an economic reality. I was in favor of a stimulus that focused on infrastructure, like David talked about, our basic investment so that we have that 321 bridge so we can go to Caldwell County without, you know, having wrecks, making sure that we fix the potholes on I-40, that we can actually get our goods and services to market. Those things are important, and that's what the stimulus should have been about. But the main part should have been incentivizing small businesses. That's where real economic growth occurs. The majority of Americans are employed by small business. That's the lifeblood of our economy. And rather than doing that, we had a costly failure. Well, this last year, it was in their hands. And what we've seen since August is that it's now in our hands. Our way forward is in our hands. I'm constantly asked, what can I do? Well, let me tell you the plan. And I want you to realize that what we have is the capacity to make change, to make tomorrow better than it is today. And the fact is, everything we announce, every discussion we've had here this morning, every speech, it's not about roads or bridges. It's not about, this beautiful view that we have when we look out our window, the Blue Ridge Mountains. It's not this special place that we have in western North Carolina that people want to live in. It's our people.